Hello guys, it's been a while, but we are back and we are here to do some more exciting stuff. First of all, thank you very much for everyone's crate. There's a resident. Let me just stop here. There's already a resident in that place. That's an office. But we had a world tour last episode, and I just want to quickly say, you guys were crazy. There's so many views on it. A lot of people really, really enjoyed catching up with the world, and of course, it's definitely changing, and it's changing every single time. So it's just really, really cool to see all the cool comments, the suggestions, and all the really insane things that are going on in the world as well. For me, at least, I like to kind of put it all together and see what happened. And man, there is a lot of cool stuff happening in the world right now. And I've got a lot of cool stuff to go on in the future right now as well. Because I've kind of had a little bit of a brainstorming session a few weeks ago, and I again came up with a lot of ideas just recently. And really, what we're going to be doing now is we're just going to be taking this city a few more steps up to where we were. So, first of all, I've gone ahead and let's just have a walk through this area here and see what's happened. And man, it's going crazy. Look at that. Definitely turning out very, very nice. And this whole part here, because I just want to quickly get you guys in the zone of where this is. This is still part of the market area. This is going up towards our palace where it's going to start getting a little bit more grand. It's going to be where the king, I assume, and queen, or whoever we write into this lore, live. And as we go around here, it goes from something a bit more industrial, still kind of very wealthy feel, to something that's going to be a bit more clean, a bit more palatial-like, I think it would be the word. Just something that looks like it's part of the palace. And that's where we start getting things like this. I've also got a little hanging basket I thought maybe works, I don't know. But it's an interesting little thing, and it's worth a try. So that is what's happened over there, but this is still part of the market area. We've still got shops, we've still got things like that, and over here will be one of the shops, and over here will be another one. And the feeling that we are going for here, because it's kind of important to think about what, for me at least, what's going on as you're walking through here, and you're kind of just taking in the sights. That's the whole point of this. We want pretty things to look at, and we want to just take in some of the sights as we go. So as we're going here, you see this area, I really wanted to open up in each direction. And the thing that we're doing there is we are using these diagonal pieces here. So we're not making this a square. We would normally, well, rectangle really. We would normally go like that. And also we're dipping these in. So we've got one over there, one pillar, and another pillar there. So it's just kind of forcing your perspective to make it feel like it's even wider than it really is. So as you come out here, just now keep that in mind. And as we come out here, it just feels like it really opens up completely. But if we had some of these things out, probably, I mean, we could really pull that one there, but let's just say we did that. Picture that there. And as we come out here, that'll be still, as we come up, still pretty blocked off. So a nice little trick we've got going on there. And I think it's working very well to just make this area feel very wide and open. Besides that, also, we've got a nice little pond over here, well, river thing, which we got to work out where that water's coming from. But I think that's a nice little start to this area, and it just brings us on to, like, the next stage in this spot and the next phase of this market in the building. And also, by the way, there's some really, really cool stuff around here. But besides the world tour, which is, as I say, crazy, and it's so good that you guys really enjoyed it, we also had a pretty crazy thing that we did, a 24-hour stream on Twitch, and that was pretty nuts. A lot of people came around. I saw a lot of people that we hadn't seen around, and also just, man, there was some crazy, crazy things that happened in the stream, but we had a really great time, and it was a really fun and interesting experience, really, sitting for 24 hours in front of here, not playing just Minecraft, we played some other stuff, but it was just really, really cool to see how many people enjoyed it and turned up and stayed 24 hours or near 24 hours, which is insane, and it's just a cool little thing with the community. It was really, really awesome. I really enjoyed it, and it was different and really awesome to see the crazy amount of people around the channel, the crazy support around the channel, which is honestly mind blown, really. But yeah, that was just a little bit of a thing with our streaming stuff, I guess, a little bit of an update, because what happened and why we've maybe missed a few days with videos is there's a few things you need to consider with 24 hours of speaking and 24 hours of playing games. And what that is your voice really is not meant to be speaking for 24 hours. And after the stream, I thought, man, my voice is going great. I can keep speaking. There's no real trouble. I was actually kind of surprised, to be honest. I expected with my track record and my voice's track record to at least have a little bit of a scratchy throat. But I was like, that's fine. And the next day, man, I could tell you, the video would have sounded very weird. I would have been very, very scratchy sounding when I would have recorded a video. So we've had to take a few days just to let our voice recover. But you know what? It was so worth it. We had a really interesting experience, I guess. Really great time. And just in general, I mean, something you don't do every day. And for a whole day. So definitely a fun time there. Now, let me just check this out. I'm just trying to create something that in this area that's a bit more natural looking. Like a bit more like a real wall, if that makes sense. And I think that's working very, very well there with those textures and those things there. Yeah, that's looking really, really good. Do you guys remember this thing? The ship. We haven't really finished it yet, so I've decided to quickly do a bit of work. And I want to show you guys what's going on and how we can make this area here complete, really. And besides the dock, I think we could really call this area out the front here fairly close to completion. We got that piece there. We got this piece here. We need the dock and that there. And then we can start just working our way all the way across there and getting the whole place looking really, really fine, I think. So what we needed to do here, there's only two very small things we need to do. We needed to fix up this front piece, and we needed to fix up this area down below. And I've kind of got the shaping and stuff done now with this. I think the best thing that we could do is we got to think about what the people on the ship need, what they want in here, and how they would survive at sea. And I think what we'll have to do is we'll have to make a little bit of a galley, which, if you don't know, that's where the food comes from in the ship. So we'll have like a kitchen, basically a kitchen. It's just a kitchen on a ship. I don't know why there's so many different words for things, but it's a kitchen. That's it. So we'll have a little bit of a kitchen for stuff to be cooked for the sailors, the people on board, the people traveling with the ship. Of course, there's the travelers that have come on from the agency down there. We've got obviously this place here, which is complete right now. So we'll just close that area there. But over here, this is what I was thinking would be really cool, is having this as the front storage compartment, I guess. This is more, I don't know what would normally be stored here, but I'm thinking more smaller things, more things of value or something like that. So as you come in here, there'll be a little bit of a door, walk down here. And I thought that little bit of step makes it feel a bit cooler, I guess. And then we'll have a whole bunch of stuff just stashed in here. Maybe some valuable items, some things along those lines, just interesting sorts of things like that. And the sun's going down. We really need to sort that out. I mean, as I say, very often we miss out on so much of the game because we don't have any sunlight, but the ability to play at night. That's, I really wish we could. Really, really do. So there we go. Let's just get this area in here done. And this is a fairly simple build here. Basically, we're just going to go with the similar design to what we've done before. But I want the walls to look a little bit more interesting than your average, just plain flat wall. And do we really... Yeah, you know what? The sun will light. The light will be all right. We'll still be able to see what we're doing. It's just a pity that we don't get to see all the things. We don't get to play as much with light just because of the mobs at night. I wish there was a simple way in Minecraft without spamming torches or spamming animals around the place to be able to play like that. But sadly, we don't have that option. I really think that we really need some mossy planks in this game. I don't know why. I've just kind of got that feeling. I've just got that thought right now that mossy planks would go really well to add in a little bit of a texture to these ones here. Just a random thought, I guess. But that was pretty much all I really thought we needed to do. And now we can see what this place looks like. And in fact, this needs to go. That there. And then we put in one of those there. Yep. And over there as well. However, this, I don't know. That's a bit too light. The real trick we're going with over here, by the way, is we want this area over here, even though we're using oak, I want it to be a bit more, basically the idea is I don't want the oak to be the prominent block. The oak is a very, very dark, block, and we want to make it a bit darker than what it is right now. So if we do this here, with a bit of spruce on this side, that's kind of the color I was hoping for when we start putting in these fence posts around it. And I think maybe what we may be better off doing is taking these ones away and putting in some spruce instead, just to check out how it looks and what color it does to the block. Because of course, look at that. See that? I think the difference is having that in front of it just breaks it up, and you just see these little pieces. There's a little bit of a shadow around the blocks and stuff like that. And speaking of shadows around the blocks, by the way, this is kind of a weird tangent to go on, but have you guys been checking out the most recent texture changes? Because there are some pretty interesting texture changes in the upcoming texture pack that's already been released. for the default game. And I'm not too sure, many people tell me one thing and then they tell me another thing, and I'm not too sure what is going on at the moment, whether or not we are getting the changes made to the game eventually, or if it's just a texture pack the whole time. But really, I don't know. There's a few very interesting changes to it. Maybe we could go check out what these changes look like around the city, by the way. And that is why I've got the texture pack on here, mixed in with my own texture pack. So we got the water that changes, but we've also got the sky, and we've also got all this other stuff. So I thought we'd play around with this, and I'll show you some of the cool changes and some of the things. And you can kind of see, well, let me just more put it this way. In terms of what's happening with the texture changes and stuff like that, they are really, really cool. It's good to see that the game's being changed, and it's good to see that there's a lot of, like, there's the desire to make the game better. But the way that they're going around it, I think there's a few things we do need to give some feedback on. And, of course, this texture pack is available to you guys right now. Hopefully I'll remember to put a link or something for you guys to download it. If not, just go on Twitter and try find it over there. I think it was posted by Minecraft, the Minecraft Twitter account, if I remember correctly. But basically, some of the things that are kind of cool, I really, really love these. Look at these blocks. These blocks look really, really cool, the note blocks. And they work really well in terms of decorating, even though they're a redstone block. But when you have a look at this, and this was made apparent to me in a stream, is you can see over here, there's a shadow that's been made on the block. And a lot of these blocks have been, like, textured with shadows. And really, that's kind of the whole idea of this, the smooth lighting in the game, is to create the shadows on the blocks, not for the blocks themselves to create shadows. If you have a look at majority of the other blocks, they don't actually have shadows in them, which is kind of strange. And I think that could be something that really does, might not work. Because, I mean, picture this. Actually, I think I've got some of these in my inventory. As we do this, just stacking up a wall of blocks that have been shaded, each one's always got a shadow on the bottom, and it just creates a very repetitive texture. But that's not actually the worst of things. I feel like that might still have a place. But that's just something to think about. But overall, the place just doesn't feel quite as default Minecraft, naturally, of course. But it just doesn't feel like I'm playing the base game. It really feels like I've downloaded a texture pack, which I have, and I'm playing with that. But hopefully there's a few things that'll be fixed up and changed and stuff like that. One of the big ones that I'm really concerned about, and this is why I think it's important to kind of look at the whole thing instead of just a few textures, is having people who have built their worlds over many years and many months, like in our case here, there's a lot of things that you've relied on. For instance, these bone blocks over here to be kind of not separate blocks, but as soon as we change over to this, there's these weird lines that come around here, and I'm down for a challenge, but I don't like the idea that our builds are going to be broken because of it. Like, there's just a lot of these very repetitive things in here, and that is a little bit of an issue for me, because of course we'd have to change up every single block in this place. However, bone blocks do kind of work good in columns, so I could give it that. I could really say that we can still get them to work, but I really don't want to have all my builds broken because of them. And then also, by the way, around here, this area actually surprisingly doesn't look bad at all. I think it looks quite good, in fact. The only thing that I could maybe critique around this are these very straight, like, lines that are coming from the planks. The planks normally are kind of more messy, I guess, and now they're just very, very solid lines that are going across there. And I don't know if I like that quite as much, but I could get used to it, to be completely honest. We could take this area and really use that to make it look a bit more wealthy, make it look a bit more, I don't know, clean. But that's not the look we're going for. We were going for a bit more of a messy, clean still, but a bit more messy sort of build style, and it doesn't work quite as good as I thought it did. But here's one of my favorite changes. There's two favorite changes of mine to these textures, and I thought I'd quickly put them out there. First one, trapdoors. How good do they look? I love that color that's come out from them. In comparison to the normal oak, that's really, really good. And the old oak trapdoors also, I mean, by the way, when I say that, I mean also the oak doors and also the ladders have had a little bit of a change to them. But they look really, really good. And I'm very, very happy with those changes. And the other thing that, the plants also look pretty cool. The flowers look very, very vibrant, and I like those as well. But the other thing that's a really, really good change, and I think I've got some stuff in here to show you, here we go, is some snow. So previously, snow was very, very repetitive, and it just didn't look quite good. And this, honestly, is a very good change, is this over here. Look at that. That snow actually looks really, really good. Can I jump up here? I can. That snow looks really, really good. And in fact, when you go out to the snowy biome that we've built, it just works so much better than what we've had before. Here's just a very quick comparison of the other old snow block. So you can tell, very, very cool changes and some very interesting ones as well. But hopefully, we can always just wait and see what happens. But hopefully we do get some really cool textures out of this. And there are some things that definitely do need changing. So let me show you what's happened in here very, very quickly, because we've done a bit of work around here. First of all, let me just step back. We've got some stairs. And I've been having a look around this place and trying to think about what we're going to do, how we're going to make this work. And a large amount of the time, what really helps is just to make things a bit more tighter and compact and fill them in. And putting in these stairs over here, making them a little bit longer, really works very well to make this area just a bit more cozy and fill out all the blank spaces, which is pretty useful, actually, to be honest. Now, let me just check. No creepers around here. Good. So I've decided we could maybe put a few things, just put a few odd stuff around the place, like some gold blocks, some diamond blocks, a dragon egg being transported. Things like that that are being transported on the ship of more value, of course, even though realistically I feel like iron blocks are more valuable to us in the world than what the gold blocks are at the moment. And definitely the diamonds are getting more and more expensive the more we burn them in lava. So that is that area over there. But then up here on like the front upper deck, I guess, I don't know what the actual word would be for this, but I decided this area here was pretty plain and I wanted to do something a bit more interesting. And ideally, I would like to have got a bigger anchor, but I thought, you know what, the anchor will probably get stored here. Even though the anchor might probably hang off the edge, this won't work very well off the edge. So I thought maybe put a little hole over here, put the anchor over here, and then have a little bit of a mechanism on this thing to pull up the anchor. So it just creates a little bit of extra thought to the build and also just adds in a bit more function, I guess, because realistically, you're not going to get these things to work, but they're more interesting when they've got something like this. Now, one thing I'm not too sure about was this over here. Getting in the rope, which is not really rope, but getting in the rope over here to go down that way, I don't think that works very well. So perhaps we'll be better off just doing nothing over there for now, keeping this over here like this, and we'll see how we feel about it, because it just looks a bit silly with the big fence post going over the top there. So we're probably better off just keeping it like this. I think it will work pretty well. And we'll just try out a few other things as well in this area. Obviously it's all still a work in progress. But let's just have a look at that. Yeah, that's very, very good. Now, a few things, and I've actually forgot the name, because I actually found out that these have a proper name. And this is also just for more function to the ship. When the ship's out at sea, and water's coming over the sides, it really can't just keep staying on top of the deck here, because else the ship's really not going to be a ship. It's going to be more of a submarine and not a functioning one at that. So what I decided would be cool is, okay, maybe that is actually, you know what, that actually might work. Even though it's actually underwater, it might actually work. But putting in these little things here, which are basically things to get the water to run off onto the edge there. And are these just a little bit under the water? Yeah, but that's all right. That's not a big problem. In fact, that could be an issue when we get the update to Minecraft in 1.14 with the water. That could be an interesting one, but who knows how that's going to work. So, I mean, that's just a guess, I guess, but kind of interesting. So there we go. We put those in there and then line this one up here. It's hidden anyway, so we don't really have to worry about that then. But look at that. Those are just some extra little things that just add a little bit of its own feel to this ship. Oh, that one actually can't be like that. We'll have to do that one just because that's an end piece there. So just like that, adding in a little bit of extra life to the ship, adding in something a little bit different as well, I guess, something you wouldn't think of immediately. But just over time, these small things really make a big difference. And look at that, really turning out very, very nicely. Do I have my rockets on me? I do. Wonderful. Let's go for a little bit of a fly off in this direction here, if we can fly. Perfect. Had to spam spacebar on our keyboard there a few times, but yeah, look at that. That ship's definitely looking really, really good from the outside and also the inside as well. So for today, guys, I think we will call that our episode. I've got a lot of stuff to do over here, and I'm definitely going to get to work with it. It's becoming a real behemoth over here now. I've got to definitely get in here, get this piece around there, and just a lot of planning. So that's going to be a very big task that we're going to be dealing with in the very near future. But for today, guys, thank you very, very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.